next question comes from Mitch in San Dimas, California. Mitch writes, my lady friend insists the EDTA in my Vaseline intensive care is ruining the environment. That stuff's in everything. Is she right? Should I make her happy and just get rid of it? Now, Mitch, Ms. Beautyphile is a science and cosmetic show and not a relationship advice column, but I'll give you the down low and let you two talk it out. So, what's EDTA and where does it come from?
Enter a dark laboratory where a mad scientist combines ethylene diamine, formaldehyde, and sodium cyanide to create an ingredient named ethylenediaminetetraacetic acid, or EDTA, better known as the claw.
It's alive! It's alive!
The claw grabs metal atoms with its super strong chemical grip, rendering them helpless.
Oh, hi guys. EDTA is a chelate, a molecule that forms several bonds with a single charged metal, preventing it from interacting with anything else. Yikes! The claw is here to help us understand EDTA's molecular structure. Hit it, claw! At the claw center is an ethylene group with two nitrogens attached. Each nitrogen is bonded to two acetic acid units. What's acetic acid, you ask? Vinegar. The two nitrogens and all four acids radiate a negative charge, sort of like a magnetic force field, disarming metals caught in its merciless grip. It turns out the claw is not the villain here, but wayward metals that wreak havoc on life as well as carefully balanced cosmetic formulations. In everyday life, EDTA keeps tidy whiteys white by removing the metals that weaken detergents. And removes disruptive metals from victims of arsenic and lead poisoning. And fortifies foods so your morning breakfast cereal doesn't look like this. Thanks, Claw. In some ways, products in the beauty aisle are no different than food in the grocery aisle. They develop funny smells, look less appealing, and can be downright hazardous over time. Who wants a product that features bacteria, oxidation, and spoilage? Not me. In Mitch's Vaseline intensive care lotion, EDTA improves stability. It acts as an antioxidant, preventing oils and fragrances from degrading. So you say, what a lovely lotion, instead of PU. Helps out preservatives. It's been known to give preservatives a big boost by dismantling metals in bacteria's cell wall, allowing them to penetrate and do their job more effectively. Locks in color and feel. Removing metals from chemical contact within a formula guarantees that the next bottle you buy will have the same color and texture as the very first bottle purchased. In products like soaps and shampoos, EDTA is a water softener, freeing bath time from minerals that dampen suds, reduce cleansing action, and leave a ring around the tub. EDTA is pretty helpful, no? Well, before you get excited, let's talk about EDTA and the environment. It's not very biodegradable, and it has a tendency to build up in surrounding areas. The good news is that we're seeing less EDTA in our products because companies are beginning to use greener alternatives. If you're thinking of avoiding EDTA, consider this. Products without EDTA have shorter shelf lives, so they will look and smell bad in less time. EDTA makes up less than 0.1% of most cosmetic formulas. And you'll need to keep an eye out for environmentally sound alternatives. Need relationship advice? Or have an ingredient you want me to review? Then do like our friend Mitch and write me at askme@msbeautyphile.com. The next ingredient I review could be the one that you request.